Amen.
Praise to the one who is identified as the eternal word of God.
Amen.
Praise to the one who is identified as the Messiah.
Yes.
Praise to the one who is identified as the Prince of Peace. Praise to the one who is identified as the Lord of Lords, King of Kings.
Amen.
Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
Jesus is Lord. He is your King. He is our Savior. Praise His holy name forever.
Amen. So, here what is our problem as a Christian? Week after week we come to Speaker's Corner.
Yes.
And we meet with people who follow Muhammad as their prophet.
Uh-huh.
And all together, all around in the world, we've got 1.84 billion of them. That's a lot of people.
That is a lot of people.
As a Christian, I cannot accept Muhammad as my prophet. Because Muhammad comes and introduces another God alongside of introducing another gospel.
Yeah.
Therefore, he is not a prophet for Christians.
Yeah.
But today, we want to ask the question, was Muhammad a prophet of Allah or was Muhammad prophet for Muslims at the first place in 7th century? What did people say about Muhammad as he received his revelation?
Yeah, so as we always do, we're going to read Islamic sources to find out the prophethood of Muhammad and what happened in the process of him being qualified in Islamic circle to be a prophet.
So, while Quran introduces Muhammad as the seal of the prophet,
yeah,
we did look at in the past what it meant to be seal of the prophet. And according to Islamic tradition, seal of the prophet was?
The last prophet?
No,
of Muhammad, all the prophets?
Muhammad had a mole on his shoulder.
And the mole on the shoulder, yes. Thank you for reminding me.
And also, Muhammad, people identified Muhammad as a prophet because he was capable to answer three important questions.
One of them was, he knew that a child would resemble his mother and his father.
The reason child would resemble
the reason why,
his
father
or his mother.
Yeah.
And reason for that was turning the sex, former to the first discharge, that will be the reason. If it is man, child would look like a father's side. If it is woman, child would look like a mother's side.
Yeah.
Second question people ask Muhammad. Question was, what would be the first dinner in paradise? Muhammad's answer was liver fish. That would make people to think
that he was a prophet.
Was the prophet. Another question was people ask Muhammad.
The last
what hour. Is the when is the last hour? Muhammad answered as it is only known to Allah. Those were the reasons in 7th century people thought Muhammad was the seal of the prophet. People thought Muhammad was the prophet of God.
Yep.
We all have a problem with those things. But also we have a problem the way Muhammad received this revelation. We look at the Bible, people of God in the Bible received the revelation by word of God comes to them.
Yep.
They received the revelation with speaking to God.
Yeah.
And their revelation is in a peaceful manner. But we look at the teachings of Islam and then we see very disturbing ways that Muhammad is receiving his revelations. We will be asking, putting all those revelations and signs together and asking, is this a way the prophet would receive this revelation, or is this revelation is coming from someone somewhere else?
Yeah, so we're going to start reading from Sahih Bukhari, how Muhammad was qualified, one of the qualifications of his
which people, which sect of Islam?
Sahih Bukhari, yes.
Before we go to that, brother, let's first
Sunni.
So, okay.
Let's first remember what happened when Muhammad first met with angel when he had his first revelation.
Yeah. So what happened when Muhammad met angel was he felt that he was being squeezed and he never felt peace when he met angel Gabriel. Is that what you mean?
So Muhammad met with angel Gabriel yes. in 610 in a cave according to Muslim tradition.
Yeah.
Muhammad, who's supposed to be the last prophet, best example to mankind, cannot read and cannot recite anything by that time.
Yeah.
What happens is angel squeeze him and then ask him to read. Muhammad
and he couldn't
says,
read.
I can't read. Mm. Angel steps in second time. Muhammad still says, I cannot read. Angel steps in third time. And then suddenly, Muhammad starts reciting Surah 96. But what happens is after that is unique. While Muhammad feels the terror,
shall we read it, yeah?
While Muhammad feels the terror, which Muhammad receives from the angel, he wants to commit suicide, he wants to go to his wife and identify what happened.
And you crazy.
Thank you.
You liar. You speak rubbish.
And Jesus loves you.
You speak rubbish.
Jesus loves you, sir.
What is the true version?
Let's read it.
Liar. Liar.
Let's read it. Ignore him.
So,
let's read the encounter.
While Muslims, while Islamic Dawatim calls their tradition liar, we are still going to read it from their lying tradition.
Thank
As
you.
A Christian, I know Islam is false religion. Muhammad is false prophet. Quran is false book. But because you do
we
not
are.
Believe I'm that, right? I am going to your lying sources. Brother, let's read the first account.
We're exposing evil. Listen. Listen, we're exposing evil. The angel called me forcefully and pressed me so hard that I could not bear it anymore. This is your prophet speaking. He then released me and again asked me to read. And I replied, I do not know how to read. Whereupon he caught me again and pressed me a second time till I could not bear it anymore. He then released me and asked me again to read. But again I replied, I do not know how to read. Thereupon he caught me again for the third time and pressed me and then released me and said, read in the name of your Lord who has created all things. And then Muhammad says, this is what he says, that Allah's apostle returned with the inspiration. His necks twitching with terror till he entered upon Khadija and said, cover me, cover me. So he's speaking to his wife, Khadija.
So let me just understand that and we see what Muhammad Muslims are calling a liar.
I'm a liar.
Hater.
I'm reading Sahih Bukhari. I'm reading Sahih Bukhari and I'm a hater for reading Sahih Bukhari. All right.
I would encourage everyone to not only get rid of Sahih Bukhari, also get rid of Quran as well.
Get rid of the whole of Islam.
They all together.
The whole of Islam. Get rid of it.
And then they produce hate. So what you read so far,
liar, you're crazy women.
We haven't even finished. We haven't even finished. This is just the beginning.
And died for you.
Go hospital, you're crazy.
Thank you.
Let me ask you some questions.
Sir, wait. Get on the queue first. I'm going to tell you what we read so far.
He's not going to answer. He's Sahih Bukhari. He's a Shia.
So, Muhammad meets with the angel in the cave. Angel squeezes the neck of Muhammad. Muhammad freaks out and then runs to his wife Khadija.
Do you believe this story? Do you believe this story?
Well, I believe doesn't matter to you.
Sorry?
Spreading hate.
Oh, hate. By reading Sahih al-Bukhari, we're spreading hate.
No, by you speaking, you're spreading hate.
I'm reading Sahih al-Bukhari, sir. So you don't have an answer? We're going to read more.
If you don't like it, just walk away, sir.
Exactly.
That's it.
Shall we read it more?
Yes, finish it.
And then it says, but after a few days, Waraka died. It says, cover me. I'll go from there.
Okay, tell
he came
the story.
To Khadija.
Yeah.
Muhammad came to Khadija and he said,
cover
me.
sat on the leg of Khadija.
Lap of Khadija, yes.
Yeah.
They covered him till his fear was over, and then he said, "Oh Khadija, what is wrong with me?" Then he told her everything that happened and said, "I fear that something may happen to me." But after a few days, Waraka died, and the divine inspiration was also paused for a while. And the Prophet became so sad as we have heard that he intended several times to throw himself from the tops of mountains, and every time he went up the mountain in order to throw himself, Gabriel would appear and say, "Muhammad, don't do it, Muhammad." Shall I give you the reference? Sahih Bukhari volume 9? Is that me? Is that me?
No translation.
Sahih Bukhari volume 9, just go and read it. No, I don't write Sahih Bukhari. It's not my translation.
Last time when I checked,
yeah, it is. Yeah.
Brother was you read Arabic? Muslim. It has been translated by Muslims.
Exactly.
Arabic is the same.
Translated
Muhammad
by Muslims.
Muhammad freaked out what happened to him.
Four Muslims.
He wanted to commit suicide, but thanks to angel, steps in Muhammad and then helps Muhammad
can you answer this
to
question?
Not commit suicide.
Can you answer this question first?
So while Muhammad receives his first revelation, let's see, as the time went on between 23 years, how revelation continued to come to Muhammad.
Okay.
Snoring one.
Volume 9, I told you. Volume 9, Sahih al-Bukhari.
Who wrote it?
Sahih al-Bukhari, are you there?
This is the Muhsin Khan translation.
Who did the translation?
Muhsin Khan
translation. Show me.
Yeah, we're giving the reference. Go and see it.
No,
everyone can
reading.
Go and check the reference out. Alright, okay.
So let's see. While it took 23 years for Muhammad to receive the full Quran,
another Sahih al-Bukhari.
Let's see how those revelations come as the time went on.
Snoring?
Remember the first Snoring, revelation. Yeah. He freaked out what happened to him. Let's see what else happened to Muhammad, brother. Are you focused?
Narrated Safwan bin Umay from his father, who said, "A man came to the Prophet while he was at Ji'rana. The man was wearing a cloak which had traces of kulka or sufra. The man asked the Prophet, 'What do you order me to perform in Umrah?' So Allah inspired the Prophet divinely and he was screened by a place of cloth. I wish to see the Prophet being divinely inspired. Umar said to me, 'Come, will you be pleased to look at the Prophet while Allah is inspiring him?' I replied in the affirmative. Umar lifted one corner of the cloth and I looked at the Prophet was snoring." I'll say it slowly. Your Prophet was snoring, getting the revelation. The sub-narrator thought he said the snoring was like of a camel. Does this bother you Muslims? Or do you know what
Muhammad
I'm talking about?
Muhammad received his revelation.
Why are you laughing?
While he snores like a camel. Brother?
It's funny.
What the sound of camel look like?
I don't know. Do you know how a camel sounds? How does
snoring
a camel,
camel
sound?
Snoring camel.
It says a camel here. It says a camel. So how does a camel sound? I would be a bad impression of a camel. I can't do it.
So, Muhammad
something like that.
Muhammad received his revelation while he snores like a camel.
Sahih al-Bukhari.
That is identified as the Prophet of Allah. So let's see.
Wait. Let's give the reference.
Sahih
al-Bukhari, volume 3, number 27. No, book 27, number 17. I'm giving you a reference so you can go and check it out.
Okay, good.
Shall we move on now? I'm giving you a reference.
No, you write it down.
He's right. He's telling you write it down.
I'm asking you to show me who translated it. Show me. I want to know who's written this.
Sir, take out your phone.
Oh, you're so dumb.
Take out your phone and read Sahih al-Bukhari volume 3.
You are reading right now.
Yes, Sahih al-Bukhari volume 3. Show me. I'm giving you the reference.
They've given you the translation.
So while we saw Muhammad received this revelation like snoring a camel,
yeah.
Snoring like a camel, also we see again in the biography of Muhammad that that he received this revelation that is like a newborn calf.
And he was all flushed and he became moon like a newborn calf. Ibn Kathir, The Life of Muhammad, page 307. Yeah? We're giving you a reference.
So already we've got already the people are testifying that Muhammad is receiving his revelation while he is making the sound of animals.
Exactly.
That's
what the seerah.
That is the time Allah is giving the revelation to Muhammad.
Yes. So we gave you the hadith, we've given you the seerah, and we're going to move on.
Now let's look at another example.
To another hadith.
How did Muhammad receive this revelation? His lips spoke rapidly and recite and memorize the revelation. He was speaking so fast, that was the way he was receiving the revelation. Brother, can you read the hadith for us?
I can't read so fast. Shall I read it fast or I'm joking? Okay. Sahih Bukhari, volume 1. Book 1, number 4. Reference again. Your ears are not hearing. That's the problem.
I already told references, translations from the Hussein Khan. Brother, let's read it.
Attack Islam all the time.
You're scared, ain't you? You're scared, isn't it?
No, you are scared. Why don't you?
Just answer the questions about Muhammad.
You know what? This will lose the crowd. I'll just read the lips part. Yeah. Narrated Sa'id bin Jubar, Ibn Abbas, and the explanation of the statement of Allah, move not your tongue concerning the Quran to make haste therewith. Allah's apostle used to bear the revelation with great trouble and used to move his lips quickly. How do you do that, Hatun? Oh, no, I'm not going to do it. With inspiration, Ibn Abbas moved his lips. I am moving my lips in front of you as Allah's apostle used to move his lips.
So, Muhammad receiving his revelation.
That's how we started.
As he receives his revelation,
you're not listening.
He moves his lips very, very fast. If my voice is audible, just walk away, sir. So that was the second one. Now let's look at the third way. How Muhammad received his revelation. Listen carefully, because you will notice Muhammad is receiving his revelation as the buzzing of bees could be heard around his face. That is the way Muhammad, who's supposed to bring the revelation of Allah, is receiving revelation. Buzzing bees is around his face. Brother, can you read it?
Yes, of course. This is the seerah again, page 306. Imam Ahmed stated that Abd al-Razak related, quoting Yunus Salim, who said Yazid dictated to him from Ibn Shubab, Rahab, I heard Umar al-Khattab say, when the revelation came down to the messenger of God, it will be heard like the buzzing of a bee near his face. Do you know about this?
Are you trying to convince us? Are you trying to convince each other?
You said that the buzzing of
it's not you yourself aren't
ensure.
Is David a prophet? Is David a prophet? What are we talking about? What are we talking about whether David is a prophet?
Why are Muslims always scared when we talk about Islam and Muhammad? Why can't you not defend this? You can't even defend this.
I know it is very stupid to read from the Islamic tradition that Muhammad received this revelation with the sound of the beast around his waist. I know those things are very stupid. And I know, but 1.84 billion people are following this man
exactly
with this things Muslim call stupid.
Yes.
So let's continue.
Let's continue with the content, yes.
So, Muhammad received this revelation by hearing the sound of the beast, which makes sounds around his face. And the next one is, as Muhammad received his revelation, he hears the ringing of the bells, which causes him pain and sweat. So listen very carefully. As the brother reads, you will hear sound of the bells are causing Muhammad to sweat and have pain. This is the way Muhammad is receiving his revelation.
All right. Sahih al-Bukhari, volume 1, book number 1, book number two. Hadith Allah's apostle.
Hadith number two,
yes. Oh Allah's apostle, how is the divine inspiration revealed to you? And Allah's apostle replied, sometimes it is revealed like the ringing of a bell.
Ding, 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 ding.
Yeah, I don't know how you do it. This form of inspiration is the hardest of all. And then this state passes off after I have grasped what is inspired. Sometimes the angel comes in the form of a man and talks to me and I grasp whatever he says. Aisha added, verily I saw the Prophet being inspired divinely on a very cold day and noticed the sweat dropping from his forehead.
What does that sound look like? Muhammad is receiving his revelation with the ding, 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 ding bells. He needs to identify that is the voice comes from angel.
Yeah.
And in very cold day, as he receives his revelation, he sweats and he is in pain.
Mm.
What kind of God, as he gives his divine revelation, brings those kind of signs to his prophet? That's clearly not the God of Bible.
No.
But we will see, what did Muhammad think the way he received this revelation? You continue, brother?
Yeah, so they overtook him, same state which used to overtake him when he used to have on being in the inspired divinely. He was sweating so much so that the drops of the sweat were dropping like pearls, though it was a cold wintry day.
Wow. Even it's cold winter day, in Arabia, it's not 5 degrees cold, it's 20-something, okay? It's like in cold days.
Yeah.
Yet Muhammad, as he received the revelation, he sweats. That's the way Allah puts Muhammad through his angel under the pressure that Muhammad can receive the revelation.
Okay, let's continue.
Another way Muhammad received the revelation is suffers from headaches and he faints. Listen carefully what brother is going to read it for you. Give attention to the suffering from the headaches.
So,
and
the Sirah says, Abu Naim related from a tradition of Kutab that Ali bin Kurab related to him, Hurai, who said when revelation came down to the messenger of God, he would get a headache. What do you think, Muslims?
So what?
Muslims. What kind of God? What kind of God? As he gives the last revelation to the Muhammad, to the his prophet, force him to have headaches, puts him into the faint, makes him to sweat. That doesn't look like
that's not from God.
Message of peace and message of
that's
love
not
at all.
At all.
As Muhammad receives his revelation, Muhammad goes through the suffering. He goes through the suffering.
Yes.
What kind of God puts his prophet through that? Let's look at the last one.
Yes.
While Muhammad receives his revelation, remember, Muhammad is a white prophet with the black slaves. His face turns to red and he breathes heavily. His face turns to red and he breathes heavily.
Why does his face turn red? Can a black man's face turn red?
He was a white man.
Exactly. So he was a white man. That's why his face was turning red. Did you know that Muhammad was a white man? Did you know that?
That's not our topic. Let's focus on that.
Oh, okay. No. I just want to engage
you. Yeah, can you
read the hadith? Can
you read the hadith?
There it is. Okay, I will start from narrated Safwan bin Yalam Umay. I wish I could see Allah's apostle at the time he was being inspired divinely. When the Prophet was at Al-Jaran and was shaded by a garment hanging over him, and some of his companions were with him, a man perfumed with a scent came and said, oh Allah's apostle, what is your opinion regarding a man who assumes ihram and puts a cloak after perfuming his body? The Prophet waited for a while and then the divine inspiration descended. Whoa, the divine inspiration came upon Muhammad, Umar pointed out to Yala, telling him to come. Yala, come and push his head. The Prophet's face was red. He kept on breathing heavily for a while, and then he was relieved. Bukhari, volume 6.
61.
61, 508.
So he was relieved from the revelation. But by the time revelation came, his face turns red.
Yep.
And he breathes heavily. As we look at all those symptoms, the way Muhammad received this revelation, we see actually people write about those kind of things. And philosophers identify this as not coming from God, not coming from Allah, but coming from demons.
Exactly.
Coming from demons.
So basically, Muhammad was inspired by Satan.
Not from God.
And demons, not from God. So how can you trust a man who's inspired by demons? How can you trust a man who is lying to you, inspired by demons? How can you trust a God like that? Muslims, answer that question.
Let's read and then see what is the foster mother of Muhammad said while Muhammad having those sentences.
Name answer.
Wait, he's answering. I'm listening to him.
It says Jibrail is a Satan.
What is your evidence that Jibrail came to Muhammad?
Yes, all the stories mentioned.
What is your evidence that Jibrail came to Muhammad?
When you read the history of Muhammad,
okay,
you will see that the angel came. He said, "I am Jibrail."
Okay, so
same angel came to Jesus Christ.
Let
him
respond.
Is that
let me just say one sentence and then you respond.
So if that is Gabriel, sir, if that is Gabriel, why did Muhammad want to commit suicide? And why did he want to drop off a mountain? Why?
Because it was a big thing for him. He didn't use on that stuff.
No.
Let me respond also. Okay. Let me make a point about my brother.
It was a demon. It was devil. That's
when
why.
When he saw the angels and those things, he said, maybe I am crazy. Maybe I am.
Yeah, so he was crazy.
He wanted to attempt suicide, but the angel came. He said, no, you are not. You are not bad. Let's say.
Why did he have a headache?
You are same a as messenger. You have
one. Let me add what my brother said. I am going to respond what you said. You said angel also came to Gabriel for Mary.
Stick with the topic.
You said angel also came to Mary. And an angel also came to Muhammad. So, let me respond.
For Jesus Christ.
While angel comes to Mary to announce the birth of Lord Jesus Christ. Brother.
Listen,
I'm speaking. Listen.
Yeah.
So, angel came to Mary to announce the birth of Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Help me out, Christians. After Mary spoke to angel Gabriel, how many times Mary went to the top of the mountain to commit suicide? How many times?
Zero.
Zero. How many times after angel came to Mary starts sweating, fainting,
or having a headache.
How many times?
Look,
zero. It's very simple. Angel Gabriel came to Mary.
It's the same Gabriel that you said in the book of Luke when he came to Mary. Mary was actually feeling at peace. And she was like saying, be as you said, like your word. And she did not want to commit suicide like Muhammad did. No, the reason why Muhammad wanted to commit suicide, it was because it was the devil, not Gabriel.
Let's see. What the mother of Muhammad?
A messenger.
So what the foster mother of Muhammad said when she saw the way Muhammad was receiving revelation, did she say that it comes because of Allah and from Allah, or did they have alternative B? Let's read it, brother. Again, from the biography of Muhammad, page 71 to 72.
The foster mother? The foster mother?
Halima, yeah.
Are you going to repeat the same hadith again, yeah?
All right, let's read what she says. Some months after our return, he and his brother were with our lambs behind the tents, and throw him down and openly open up his belly and are stirring it up. We ran towards him and found him standing up with a livid face. We took hold of him and I asked him, what is the matter? He said, two men in white, remnant came and threw him back to our tent. His father said to me, I am afraid after this child has had a stroke. So his mother, who asked why he had brought him, when I had been anxious for his welfare and desirous of keeping him with me, I said to her, God has let my son to live so far and I have done my duty. I am afraid that ill will befall him. So I have brought him back to you as you wished. She asked me what happened and gave me no peace until I told her. Now listen, when she asked if I feared a demon possessed him, I replied, yes. That's his foster mother. She thought that he has a demon possessed. It's not just your own sources from Sahih Bukhari, even his own foster mother thought that.
Okay, now you finished your...
Yet, when we look at the Bible, okay.
Not yet.
When we look at not the
yet.
Bible,
not yet.
We
2 minutes.
Do not see...
About 5 minutes.
We do not see that's prophet not of God claims to have the revelation, yet they want to go and commit suicide. We do not see when people claim to have the revelation, angel does not put terror in their hearts. We do not see people after they have revelation or claim to have revelation from God, they do not
want to commit suicide.
Yeah, they do not want to commit suicide.
They don't feel at fear, they feel at peace. There is no sense of having a headache. It's all peace when God comes to you.
But when angel comes to Muhammad, we see there is terror in the heart of Muhammad. We see there is a fear in heart of Muhammad. We see Muhammad sweats. We see Muhammad is uneasy. And we see Muhammad is not peaceful. And what we see is, This all confirms what Bible says and points out the conditions of Muhammad regarding his revelations. Can you read Mark
chapter 9. Chapter 9, yeah?
Yeah.
This is the last verse, wait. It's the last verse, yeah? Be patient, sir. Then one of the crowd answered and said, Teacher, I brought you my son. I'm reading the Bible. Who has a mute spirit, and whenever it seizes him, it throws him down.
Just one. It throws him down. Remember,
yes,
Muhammad.
That's the
fainted.
Evil spirit.
Muhammad fainted when
he foams at the mouth, gnashes his teeth.
Muhammad spoke very, very fast.
Yes. Yeah? Gnashes his teeth and becomes rigid. Then they brought him to Jesus. What did Jesus do? Beautiful. And when he saw him, immediately the spirit convulsed him. And he fell on the ground and wallowed, foaming at the mouth. When Jesus saw that the people came running together, he rebuked the unclean spirit, saying to him, deaf and dumb spirits, I command you, come out of him and enter him no more. Then the spirit cried out and convulsed him greatly and came out of him. And he became as one dead, so that many said, he's dead. So
we
Jesus healed the man.
We look at the traditions, and traditions are saying us something very important. The way Muhammad received his revelation, actually, not much to do with revelation was from God, but it has something to do with the jinn or with the devil.
Yeah.
But good thing is what we see.
Okay.
We look at the Bible and we see Jesus Christ has power over the
exactly.
demon spirit.
Jesus has power.
Are you scared to answer?
We look at the Bible, okay. And while the Bible identifies Muhammad as a false prophet, tradition tells us conditions of Muhammad is not healthy enough for Muhammad to be the prophet of God.
So, what we're saying to you, man, we'll answer your question when we come down.
You said
Jesus Christ is above all these demons. Come to him so you'll be free from the demon that is controlling Islam, and you're in bondage of this demonic religion. Come to Jesus, who's the way, the truth, and the life. God bless you.
Thank you.